Welcome to Basket of Tales, a time travel into the world of stories.
Hello everyone, this is Ms. S from Basket of Tales. Today I'm here with another interesting story from the tales of Vikram and Betal. Now this is a story of a princess Chandraprabha. And the saga continues of Vikram and Betal. Betal once again starts narrating a story riddle to Vikram. He really wants to see how intelligent and smart Vikram is. So Betal hops onto Vikram's back and they both start walking. Betal starts his story. This is a story about a beautiful princess Chandraprabha of the Kusumati kingdom. The princess is like an ordinary guy. The princess likes an ordinary guy named Manokumar. They both want to get married, but the princess always knew there would be a lot of hurdles and her father would never agree for the marriage because Manokumar was a very poor and a common man. She advised Manokumar to leave the kingdom. Because if her father gets to know about their liking for each other, he would not tolerate and might capture him and put him in a prison. Manokumar was helpless and had no choice than to leave the kingdom. Chandraprabha feels very bad, but even she feels helpless. Manokumar thought to himself, "I have to impress the king, and for that I will have to earn a lot and prove myself. But how am I going to do that?" As he was walking, he saw a magician and his troop, and they were being attacked by some robbers. Manokumar, without thinking, goes ahead and saves the magician from the robbers. He fights with them bravely. The magician was very impressed with Mano for saving his life, and he says, "Thank you for saving us from the robbers. Tell me, what is your wish? And I will grant it to you as a token of gratitude and reward. You can ask me anything." Manu narrates the entire story to the magician, and he asks him if there was a way he could help him. The magician instantly gets an idea and he says, "Well, I can do something. What if I give you the power, and with that power, you can stay with the princess forever in disguise?" Manokumar couldn't understand what he was trying to say. The magician then pulls out a ring from his pocket and puts the ring on Manokumar's hand. "This ring is very powerful," he says. "If worn on right hand finger, you will turn into a woman, and if it is worn by the left hand finger, you will turn into your original self." But the biggest concern was, how would Manokumar get inside the palace? Magician thinks of a plan and he disguises himself as a priest, and Manokumar transforms himself into a woman with the help of the ring. They then go to the king's court. The magician's son too accompanies them. The magician introduces Manu as his would-be daughter-in-law and tells the king that he and his son were going for a pilgrimage and he wanted a safe place for his daughter-in-law to stay until they returned back. And the only place that he could think of was the king's palace. The king couldn't say no to the priest and he agrees. The magician and his son leaves the palace and Manokumar, disguised as woman, stays back. The king then tells his daughter Chandraprabha to take care of Manokumar, who changed himself into Manokumari. Manokumar couldn't believe his luck. As he continued to stay in the palace, he made friends with Chandraprabha. However, he notices that she is always sad and depressed, thinking about Manokumar all the time. One day he decides to reveal the truth, as he couldn't see her like that. Chandraprabha, upon hearing the entire story, couldn't believe it. Then Manokumar shows her how he can quickly transform into Manokumar and Manokumari. Days passed. Manokumar continued to manage. He would change into Manokumari in everyone's presence and Manokumar when Chandraprabha was alone. Meanwhile, one of King's minister's son, Shashi, starts liking Manokumari. He goes to Chandraprabha and expresses his desire to get married to Manokumari. However, Chandraprabha, who knows the truth, declines his proposal. Shashi then goes to his father and he expresses his desire to get married to Manokumari, and he tells him that by any means he wants to get married to her. The minister then assures his son, "Don't worry, my son, I will convince the king and get you married to her." One fine day, the minister decides to go and talk to king about his son's desire to marry Manokumari. The king finds no problem in it and he agrees for their marriage. However, he forgets that Manokumari is actually priest would-be daughter-in-law. The same day, Manokumar accidentally hurts his left hand finger, and apparently it's the same finger that would help him transform back into Manokumar. He starts panicking and tries to fit the ring into the wounded finger. Unfortunately, he fails and he continues to be Manokumari. The king decides to make an announcement about the minister's son Shashi's wedding with Manokumari, and this shocks Chandraprabha and disguised Manokumar. But the king calls it as his final decision. Manokumar feels helpless and he tells Chandraprabha, "I came here only for you and I took magician's help so that I can be with you. Now how can I get married to minister's son?" He once again attempts to put the ring back into the wounded finger so that he can tell the truth to everyone, but in vain. Meanwhile, the king makes all the arrangements for their wedding and gets them both married. This leaves Chandraprabha yet again sad and anxious. The magician somehow gets the news of Manokumari's wedding and he immediately rushes to the kingdom in anger and questions the king about his decision. He says, "King, I trusted you and left my would-be daughter-in-law at your palace and you cheated me. I will teach you a lesson." He threatens to put his magic spell on the king if he doesn't bring Manokumari back. The king gets into pressure and he says, "I'm sorry, I know I have done a big mistake. Now Manokumari is already married and I can't do anything. But what I can do is instead have my daughter married to your son." This proposal impresses the magician and he quickly agrees, because his son can now rule the kingdom by getting married to Chandraprabha. The entire kingdom gets ready for Chandraprabha's wedding. The minister's son, who is now married to Manokumari, gets the news and he tells her, "Did you know about your best friend's wedding? Well, she is getting married to the priest's son." This leaves Manokumar sad and heartbroken, and in spite of his wounded finger, he forces the ring into his finger and transforms back into the real Manokumar to reveal the truth to everyone. The minister's son is left speechless to see Manokumari transform into a man. Manokumar rushes to the wedding venue and tries to stop the marriage. However, by the time he reaches the palace, it's too late. Now here, Betal stops narrating the story and asks Vikram a question. Whose wife is Chandraprabha? Manokumar, with whom she was in love with? Or Shashi, the minister's son with whom she got married to? Now let me pause here as well and give you a chance to think. Whose wife is Chandraprabha? Now Vikram thinks for a while too and he says, Well, Chandraprabha is Shashi's wife because both Shashi and Chandraprabha got married following all the rituals. Manokumar no doubt loved her a lot, but she was married to Shashi ceremonially. So she is the wife of Shashi. Betal is yet again impressed with his answer and he says, Well, that's absolutely right. However, your problem is whenever you have to make a decision and tell me the answer, you speak. And as you know, when you speak, I leave and I am leaving now. Well, this is the end of the story and hope you liked it. We'll see you in the next story soon. Until then, take care.